One night, Bill and Ben couldn't sleep. They were too busy looking up at the moon and the stars. But then clouds filled the sky and the stars disappeared.
OK. Time for sleep.
Flubberweed.
All around the garden, Bill and Ben's friends were dropping off to sleep. In the part of the garden where Thistle lives, the man who works in the garden had put up a special light, which switched on in the dark as soon as it saw anything move.
What's that?
Oh, the sun's come out. That wasn't the sun. That was a light. A magic light. Oh, this is going to be fun. The sun's come out. Oh, it's gone in again.
Flubberdubberloon.
Yes, perhaps it was the moon after all. Good night.
Thistle couldn't stop laughing. She thought it such fun to wake everybody up and send them to sleep again.
I say.
Finally, Thistle tired herself out and fell asleep.
Oh, the sun's out again. Good morning, Ben.
Rubble up.
It's a lovely sunny morning. Go and tell your friends. It would be a shame for anyone to miss such a beautiful day.
However hard they looked, Bill and Ben couldn't find any of their friends. They were worried that if Slowcoach didn't have his breakfast soon, he'd feel ill. Bill thought Ben would give Slowcoach a nasty fright, so he sent Ben to fetch some lettuce for breakfast. Ben couldn't remember what Bill had sent him to fetch.
I dare say it is a lovely sunny morning, Bill, but I didn't want to wake up yet. Oh, I was dreaming of a beautiful desert. Or was it a sand pit? Flubberdubberdust. I dare say it is time for breakfast, but I've no lettuce in my cupboard.
Flubberdub.
A nut? I can't eat a nut. I haven't got the teeth for it.
Flubberdubberdub.
You know, I'd have to suck that nut, Bill. It'd take me weeks.
Ben suddenly felt very tired.
Lettuce. This is more like it. Nuts indeed.
What a flubberdum.
Bill and Ben didn't understand why the sun was out in one place, but not in another.
Flubberdum?
Here comes the sun, thought Ben. But Bill thought the sun would shine more brightly. Ooh, oh, Roboto.
It's my new shiny treasure. I thought it might be the sun.
Dear Flobbadobadon.
You're right. If the sun's shining over there, this can't be the sun. But what is it?
Robbalobbleed.
Oh, good idea. We'll ask Weed.
The man who works in the garden carries that shiny treasure at night. It's a light. But it's not a light anymore.
And it's not a shiny treasure. I'd better take it back.
That was the shortest day I can ever remember.
Oh, Flobber night.
Yes, that was the shortest night ever.
Oh, what's happening? 1 minute it's day, the next it's night. Oh, I don't know whether to sleep or wake. I'm going to hibernate.
Oh, Flobbadobber.
No, it's not much of a summer, Bill. Look at the sun. Not very big, is it?
I thought the sun lived in the sky.
That's not the sun. It's stuck on the wall of the house.
Bill and Ben wanted a closer look at this strange new sun.
It's not the sun. It's Thistle turning that light on and off.
Flobbadob.
Yes, we must stop her. And we must pay her back.
Ben saw a strange shadow on the ground, and Bill saw that it was made by a moth in front of the light.
Yes. Let's give Thistle a fright.
What's that? Oh, a monster! Help! Oh, go away, monster, please!
Has the monster really gone?
Flobbadobadite!
Well, yes, I did make it go on and off. Only a bit of fun. I won't do it again, I promise.
Flobbadobadite!
Yes, I will stay awake all night. I'll make sure no one turns the light on and off. I promise.
At last, Bill and Ben could settle down to sleep.
Oh.
But next morning, they still felt very tired. So did Weed.
At least we got some sleep last night.
Bill and Ben slept all through the day. Later on, the man who works in the garden decided he didn't like being kept awake by his light going on and off, so he took it away. So Bill and Ben slept all through the next night as well.
Now they'll be sleeping in their pots.